setup. And if you want to go just on a media drive, or you can go to class assets for this class and grab the alien eye setup for today. Set this up so that this character, we have control to make the upper eyelid open and close, the lower eyelid open and close, and that when the eyeball moves, it moves as one particular unit. So I am going to create another circle. Now, keep in mind, once we get to more advanced setups, I have a set of controls that you're going to use that I'm going to give to you. They look like professional controls if you ever used a rig before. But for this, you can use what is set up, and that should be perfectly fine. However, keep them default. Don't try to make an interesting shape. Just use the shape as is, because it's all about functionality. The creativity comes into the setup and how you use it and how you can make it a more advanced setup. But the look of the controls when it comes to character setup is really creative. Anybody who can use Maya can do that. So, edit delete by type, history, modify freeze transformations. I'm going to name this character con. Now, we have an issue here. If I want my eyes to properly rotate, they're rotating from the center here. I don't want that. So what I'm going to need to do is go to my insert point, and I'm going to have to move it. And let's hide this right now. Let's hide this, this, this. And I need it to actually come from the back of the character. What I'm going to do is I'm going to look for this center line here, which is kind of a little difficult to see. And I'm going to hold down the B key. And snap it to right there. And the reason why I want it there is so that it rotates from the back here. Well, the hotkey is the V. Hold down the V key. And then let's do this again. Oops. We're not done with the eyes, but we still have a little bit. We have more to go. Let's just say we're not close to being complete with this. Now what I'm going to do is we're going to get this to move with this. So when the eyelid, the eyeball rotates up, the pupil moves with it. So I'm going to select the eyeball, the eyelid, constrain, and we're going to do a parent constrain. We want to make sure we got maintain offset set. Especially if you got to do something like a subdivision, or if you got to smooth it, or do something like that, because that becomes problematic. All right, let's go ahead and get the eyeball to look from left to right, right to left, wherever we want. So I'm going to duplicate this. I'm going to scale it down. It up. I'm going to rotate it along Z 90 degrees, and I'm going to align this with this, and I probably need to move my cameras out. I'm not going to worry about that. I'm going to go to Modify, Freeze Transformation, and actually let's do this Display Show All. So what we're going to do now is select the icon, select the eyeball, constrain, aim constraint, option box. Select the controller, the eyeball, constrain, aim constraint, option box. Check maintain offset and hit and click on add. For the eyes, and actually since we're here, I'm gonna go to File, Save Scene,